The second half of this lesson deals with advanced mechanisms. Basically, all the mechanisms you're going to encounter in 332 are going to be combinations of the elementary steps we've taught you so far, including the pericyclic elementary steps. But we'll typically give you the elementary steps to a mechanism. That way, all you'll need to do is be able to identify structures within the starting materials that can undergo the elementary steps, or structures within the products that can come from the elementary steps. In this way, you can step your way through a mechanism. If you're only given starting materials and products and asked to determine a mechanism, the best way to do it is to start by thinking about bonds made and bonds broken, as is done here. So many students get hung up and frustrated with this idea of being forced to write mechanisms for reactions they've never seen before. But remember that all reactions are built from the elementary steps. So every reaction that you see, every change that takes place, will have happened because of an elementary step that you've already learned about. This makes what you already know extremely powerful when it comes to writing reaction mechanisms. For instance, in this example, we see that a bond is made between carbon 1 and carbon 6. And while it may not be obvious how that bond is made, we also see that a bond is broken between carbon 1 and oxygen, which is clearly this bond. Based on what you know about the electronegativity of oxygen and the idea that resonance-stabilized leaving groups are very good, you might get the impression that this could leave by some kind of nucleophile dissociation type step. Then we can imagine using the double bond attached to carbon 6 as a nucleophile to attack the newly created electrophile at carbon 1. So this just provides one example of how you can use what you already know to reason about mechanisms. And indeed, a step like this does actually happen in the real mechanism. This is how real organic chemists reason about reaction mechanisms, from the most complex to the most simple. And now you have the ability to do it as well. Give the advanced mechanisms in your notes a shot. What you'll find is that you already have a great deal of tools at your disposal in order to accomplish these mechanisms.